Hello, this tutorial will cover using Microsoft Excel or Google Sheets to approximate integrals. In particular, we will show that Microsoft Excel or Google Sheets can be useful for solving a variety of math problems. It has built-in functionality that makes it a good tool to do so. We will see one example using its click and drag feature. And it also has a lot of built-in mathematical functions like the square root, exponential, sine, or cosine. And we'll use all of these features to approximate integrals using trapezoid, Simpsons, and the midpoint rule. And the integral that we'll consider is the integral from 0 to 1 of the square root of 2x times e to the 2x times sine of the quantity 2x. And we'll use the trapezoid rule, Simpson's rule, and midpoint rule all to approximate that integral using 10 subintervals. Let's get started. First, we'll use the trapezoid rule to approximate that integral. Recall that the trapezoid rule takes the following form, where the integral approximation is equal to the width of each subinterval, delta x, divided by 2, times the sum of the quantities including the function values at the left and the right end of the domain, and 2 times the function values at all the interior points in the integration domain. Next, let's open up Google Sheets or Microsoft Excel and get to work. Here I've opened up Google Sheets. If you've opened up Microsoft Excel, it'll work the same exact way. And recall the first integral approximation we're going to do is using the trapezoid rule. So I'll just write a title in the first box that just says trapezoid rule. Next, for the integral approximations, we need to lay down what x values we're considering. So I'll just give a little title header called f of xi. They'll just say, here we'll lay down the points between 0 and 1. Next, I want to lay down a column that will include all the function values at all those x points. So I'll just call this column f of xi. And mind you, at this point, I'm just labeling things. I haven't actually defined what any of these functions actually are yet. So if I go to the box labeled A3, I can put down the first value, 0. Next, since we're in a case where we're on an integral between 0 and 1 using 10 subintervals, we can easily figure out that our delta x is 1/10, or 0.1. So the next x value will be 0.1. After that, when we tack on an extra delta x, it'll be 0.2. Now, we could keep going all the way until we reach the right end of the domain at b equals 1. Or we can use one of Microsoft Excel's or Google Sheets features that's click and drag. So we can highlight those three boxes that we've just typed in, go to the bottom right corner of that blue highlighted region, and just drag it downwards. And as you can see, as we drag it downwards, it's basically picking up on a pattern, and we'll continue that pattern as far as we want it to go. Next, let's actually evaluate that function at those x points. Now, to evaluate functions in Excel, we have to type an equal sign. And then once we have this equal sign, we could click on different boxes in Excel to essentially perform operations. Now, I've already mentioned very briefly that Excel and Google Sheets have built-in math functions. For example, if we want the square root function, we can just type sqrt, left parenthesis, and then we'll be able to take the square root of whatever we'd like. In this particular example, we need the square root of 2 times our x value. So we can type 2 times, and the x value we want here is the one in A3. So we can click on A3. And then we can close that square root. Now, our integrand function wasn't just the square root of 2x, it was also square root of 2x times e to the 2x times sine of 2x. And there's built-in functions for the exponential as well as trig functions like sine or cosine. So we can multiply by the asterisk and type exp for the exponential function. And mind you, as I start typing these functions, if it's a function in Google Sheets or Excel, it'll bring up this little dialog window explaining a little bit of what this function is. So we can again put a left parenthesis, and type 2 times the x value that we want, which is a3. And we could either type a3 or we could actually click on a3. And that's all that we want in an exponential function, so we can close it with the right parentheses. And next, we want to multiply this by the sine of 2x. So again, we can type the asterisk for multiplication, and then type sin for the sine function, left parenthesis, and then 2 times x, which is in this case a3. And we can either type that or we can click on it. And once we have that, we can hit enter, and that'll give us our value. Now, what's really nice is that seemed like a lot of typing just for that one function value's evaluation. Now, we can click on that box, and you'll see the function that we just typed in. But if we go to the bottom right corner, we can use that click and drag feature again to click and drag it downwards. And then it'll evaluate everything that we need appropriately at all the x values. Now, for trapezoid rule, we didn't just need the function values. We needed the left and the rightmost function values to have a coefficient of 1, whereas the remaining function values, we need a coefficient of 2. So let's just make another column and call this just the coefficient of our approximation. We can just say int approx. Now, in this column, we could put a 1, meaning we want a coefficient of 1 on the leftmost point. And at the last point, at x equals 1, we can also put a coefficient of 1. Whereas in all these interior points, we could put a coefficient of 2 if we desired. And again, we could click on that 2 and just drag it downwards. And then in the next column, we can actually perform the multiplication for us. So we can take that coefficient and multiply it by the function value. So we could call this coefficient times f of our function value. And mind you, since we didn't put an equals, this is just labeling here. It's not actually performing any operation. So in this first box for D3, we can type the equals, which means we're going to try and do some arithmetic operations. And we can take our C3 times B3, enter. And we can do the same click and drag method for all those evaluations. Now, to actually get the integral approximation, we basically have to sum together all of the numbers I have highlighted right now, and then multiply them all by this delta x over 2 quantity for trapezoid rule. So we can just come back down to, say, C15, and just label this approximation is, and maybe a colon. But really, this is just a label for us, and we can move over one box. And inside this box, what we can do is say, this is equal to our delta x, which in this case is 0.1, divided by 2. And then we need to multiply this by the sum of the quantities from D3 to D13. So we can say is times, and there's a sum function that can help us out, sum, left parenthesis, and we can click and drag on all the quantities we want to add together, and then close parenthesis. And this should give us our integral approximation using the trapezoid rule. The last thing we can do if we so desired is, if we want to label this a little better, we could take this trapezoid rule, highlight the cells next to it, and go up to a merge button that says merge cells. There's also a merge cells button in Microsoft Excel as well. And we can click on that and then tell it to center it with a center align. And if we want, we can bold it or change colors, change the size, etc. Just so we know that these four columns contain our trapezoid rule. Next, we'll approximate the same exact integral, but this time using Simpson's rule with 10 subintervals as well. Now recall the form that Simpson's rule takes. It's actually very familiar to us and looks strikingly similar to that of trapezoid rule, except we have a delta x over 3 out in front, and the interior coefficients on the function's values bounce between 4, 2, 4, 2, 4, ending with a 4 before just having one function evaluation at the left and the rightmost points. Let's use Excel or Google Sheets to approximate that integral using Simpson's rule. Now we can come back to that same trapezoid rule Google sheet or Excel sheet that we had before, and we can do Simpson's rule kind of right along beside it. Now before we jump into that, we can also just resize this width of these columns. So we can just click and drag appropriately if we just want to save a little bit of space. Not that it's important. But what we can do next is just highlight this entire thing for trapezoid rule. Use Command or Control C to copy, and we can paste this kind of in a column nearby. Now we want this to be Simpson's rule, so why don't we just change this trapezoid rule name to Simpson's rule. And we can essentially use the same exact machinery we have here for Simpson's rule, except the only change is we need a different coefficient out in front of delta x over 3 instead of delta x over 2, and those interior coefficients change. So next we can go to the box labeled H4 and we change this 4 or this 2 to a 4. And every other coefficient really just needs to be a 4 for us, so we can easily go ahead and do that. And the last thing we need to do after changing those interior coefficients is, well, go to our final approximation. And instead of having that delta x over 2 or 0.1 over 2, we need that to be 0.1 over 3. And that gives us our integral approximation using Simpson's rule. And we can, of course, make some of these columns a little closer if we wanted to. We could, of course, center these columns. There's a lot of cosmetic things we can, of course, do here if we wanted. But next, we will check out midpoint rule. Finally, let's use the midpoint rule to approximate that same integral using the same number of subintervals, n equals 10. Now, recall from midpoint rule, one difference between the formulas of that is Simpson's rule and trapezoid rule are all the coefficients on the function values are 1. We also have this delta x, not over 2 or 3, but just a delta x sitting in front. One large difference that we'll have to do, though, is all the x values that we're evaluating the function at, they're actually the midpoint of all the subintervals, so we need to average the left and right sides together. Otherwise, we can use a lot of the same machinery we've already built up for integral approximations. All right, let's get to it. The first thing we can do, opening up our Excel or Google Sheets file again, is copy either Simpson's rule or trapezoid rule. Let's just copy Simpson's rule. We can Command C or Control C to copy. And we can scroll over, and then paste it again. And scroll over, resize some of the columns if we wish, but of course we want to rename this to midpoint rule so we don't get confused. The next thing we can do is, well, note from midpoint rule that all the coefficients on the interior points as well as the two function values on the endpoints are all 1. So we can change those 4s and 2s to all 1s if we wanted. The next thing we really need to change for midpoint rule is, well, we're evaluating the function at all the midpoints of the intervals. Not 0, 0.1, 0.2, but the average between both endpoints of each subinterval. So we can go up to the column L and highlight it, right-click, and insert a column to the left. And in this column is where we're going to put the next x points or the midpoints. We can call this column, say, bar xi. And the way we can do this is average the two endpoints for each subinterval. So we can say equals, open parenthesis, k3 for the leftmost point at a equals 0, plus the right side of that subinterval 0.1. And what we want to do is average them, so add them together, divide by 2. And we can use the Google Sheets or Microsoft Excel click and drag feature again, and we can drag this all the way down to 1. Now, an important thing to note here is we only really need to go to the bar xi value of 0.95. We can get rid of this last row. So let's go ahead and do that next. So we can just click, highlight, delete. And the last thing we need to do for our function or for our integral approximation with midpoint rule, since we're still multiplying the coefficients of 1 onto the function values, is, well, we need to actually evaluate those function values at the new midpoints now. So if we go to the first box, M3, we can change all those K3s to L3s, since we want it to be evaluated at the midpoints, not no longer the endpoints of the interval. Click Enter, and we get our new function value. And we can use that click and drag feature again to get all the new function values we need. And then our code has already set this up for us automatically, where it's multiplying each function value by the coefficients we need, and then it's adding them together and multiplying by delta x, except here it's still delta x over 3. For midpoint rule, we need this to be delta x over 1, or just delta x times that sum. However, you might notice something funky. Our approximation here doesn't really look good compared to Simpson's rule or trapezoid rule next to it. Now, we can go back over and look at what may have happened. Well, one thing that we see is the last bar xi value is no longer 0.95, it's 0.45. We can go in and hard code this to 0.95, the quantity we need it to be. But what actually happened was when we deleted that last row, we got rid of the xi value of 1. And because we got rid of that xi value of 1, it just averaged 0.9 and 0 and gave us the 0.45. These are common errors in computer programming, typically known as indexing errors. And while they're typically easy to fix, sometimes it's very difficult to actually find them in larger codes. And just by adding that 1 back in, we see that our integral approximation is very close and matches that of the Simpson's rule as well as trapezoid rule. So this concludes our tutorial on how to use Microsoft Excel or Google Sheets to approximate integrals. Have a nice day and happy computing.